Eight family members of a Delta variant carrier in Bocoro City, Cavite, have tested positive for COVID-19. This prompted officials to extend the lockdown in the subdivision where the Delta case was found. Antigen tests will also be conducted on the residents of some 30 nearby homes.
Wala po munang lalabas sa inyong mga tahanan. Bawal din po ang may bumisita kahit po nakamag-anak.
Meanwhile, five close contacts of a Delta variant carrier in a separate subdivision tested negative for COVID-19. Bacoor City Mayor Lani Mercado says the two Delta cases did not come from abroad, but they had traveled to Metro Manila.
San Juan City is one of the latest localities to confirm a Delta variant case. The two patients are said to have no travel history. One of them, a 25-year-old female, works outside San Juan and hasn't been vaccinated for COVID-19 at the time of infection. The second case is a 9-year-old male whose father is a colleague of the 25-year-old female. The child's mother also tested positive for the virus. San Juan Mayor Francis Zamora says this was only reported to them weeks after the patients tested positive and completed quarantine.
One thing is for sure, the number of Delta variant cases in Metro Manila and in the country are very underreported. And this is because we find out late already. So it's possible that there are really a lot more Delta variant cases around the country that we do not know, which we will eventually find out in the next few days or the next few weeks.
Zamora adds the release of genome sequencing results is too slow. Quezon City Mayor Joy Belmonte says they're now planning to buy their own genome sequencing machines to speed up the process. But experts explain genome sequencing is not a diagnostic tool.
It's not there when you that you have a variant of concern, change how they're being managed. Kaya pa rin ang paggagamot na ginagawa nila.
Philippine authorities urged to implement a so-called circuit-breaking lockdown as new COVID-19 cases in the country soared to a six-week high. The health department logged 7,186 fresh infections Tuesday, the highest since June 13. Active cases stand at over 56,000, also the highest in over a month. The health department has warned against using the term surge in describing the rising cases, especially in the capital region. But the Okta Research Group insists it fits their observation.
Right now, it's official. We are in a surge po dito sa National Capital Region. Hindi ho pwedeng baliwalain to. Pag kumalat to, and pinabayaan natin kumalat to, we will lose effective control of the epidemic. Kung maaga tayo mag-enforce ng circuit-breaking restrictions, sa tingin namin sa Okta, mas mainam yun, maingat. Mababa pa yung kaso, konti ang mahahawa, halos walang mamamatay, at yung ekonomiya masisave natin ho kasi maikli lang ho yung lockdown. So yun ho yung aming pananaw, go early, go hard po.
Health Secretary Francisco Duque agrees current COVID-19 measures should be strengthened as the threat of the Delta variant lingers.
Sinasama yun na natin, ito ang rekomendasyon ng Okta, kaya walang tigil ang ating makikipag-ugnayan sa mga pamahalaan lokal dahil sila naman ang on-the-ground implementing units no para sa ating PDITR Plus strategy. No? So, kailangan talaga gawin ang lahat para hindi magpatuloy ang nagsimula ng tumataas na mga kaso.
Tagaytay City now under general community quarantine with heightened restrictions after nearby Cavite province reported Delta COVID-19 and variant cases. A curfew will be implemented from 10 in the evening to 4 in the morning. Minors and unvaccinated senior citizens aged 65 and above are prohibited from going outside. Operations of gyms as well as indoor tourist attractions are also suspended, but outdoor tourist attractions, restaurant operations, and religious gatherings are allowed at limited capacity. The new restrictions will be in place until the end of the month.